Let's get to the news. Former President Trump has reportedly complained to advisors about how he's portrayed in the sketches created by the courtroom artist in his hush money trial. Well, I guess when you're used to being painted like this, any sketch is bound to be a letdown. President Biden suggested earlier this month that his uncle was eaten by a tribe of cannibals during World War II. Okay, man, we get it. Scranton was a tough town. South Dakota Governor Kristi Noem is facing criticism for writing in her upcoming memoir about killing her 14-month-old puppy. Even crazier, it was during a drug deal gone bad. In a new interview... Our head writer wrote that joke. In a new interview... Oh, he criticizes the other writers, but sometimes he's not right about everything. In a new interview, former President Trump's ex-attorney general Bill Barr said that Trump talked regularly about executing his rivals, not to mention co-workers. In her new memoir, actress Rebel Wilson wrote that a member of the British royal family once invited her to a drug-filled orgy at a tech billionaire's house. She didn't name names, but come on, we all know who it was. According to a new survey, a third of public school teachers believe that schools should install metal detectors. The other two-thirds are concerned their flasks will set it off. The American Lung Association recently released its State of the Air report. Apparently, it's loaded with dangerous particles such as smoke, pollen, and Boeing airplane parts. But, like, why would you woo? Woo! The restaurant chain Chipotle reportedly told employees last week they could not have chicken for their own meals because of high customer demand. Also, due to high customer demand, employees can't have the bathroom key. And finally, authorities in Florida recently seized nearly 150 pounds of crystal meth, 2 kilograms of cocaine, and 1 kilogram of fentanyl from a home in Orlando. Wow. That's almost enough drugs to have a good time in Orlando. President Biden attended a campaign event today at his headquarters in Delaware, and this is bad. Even there, he's down 4 points. The third week of former President Trump's criminal hush money trial kicked off today in New York, and you can tell the sketch artist is getting a little bored. After South Dakota Governor Kristi Noem revealed in her upcoming memoir that she killed her puppy, an ally to former President Trump said it's impossible for Noem to be selected as Trump's vice president. After all, they can't have her standing right next to an old yeller. We're gonna land this she killed a dog plane soon. We're gonna do one joke every monologue this week about how she killed a dog. Judge Juan Merchan said today that he will allow former President Trump to attend his son Barron's high school graduation, but he drew the line at telling Trump the name of the high school. The Biden administration recently announced a plan that would require all new cars to come with systems to avoid collisions with pedestrians, which explains why Elon Musk supports Trump. A cat was recently reunited with its family in Utah after it was trapped in a box filled with Amazon returns and shipped to California. Said one family member, all right, let's try Etsy. 3 zebras that escaped on a Washington State highway over the weekend were recaptured by authorities and a rodeo clown, which I'm guessing is still not enough for that rodeo clown's parents to be proud of him. Ahead of the Kentucky Derby on Saturday, the fast food chain Panera is selling a bread bowl-inspired hat, but you're gonna wanna wear it indoors. Today was National Adopt a Shelter Pet Day. Not for you! There we go. All right, we're gonna give ourselves tomorrow off. And finally, Dave & Buster's has announced it will allow customers over 18 years old to bet on arcade games. And if you want to gamble at Chuck E. Cheese, eat the pizza. The Biden administration is reportedly set to reclassify marijuana for the first time in more than 50 years, starting with Biden no longer referring to it as reefer. That's right. The Biden administration is reportedly set to ease federal restrictions on marijuana thanks to a hefty donation from some lobbyists. Former President Trump reportedly appeared to fall asleep several times yesterday in court. All right, what's going on with him? Hibernating bears don't sleep this much. I'm starting to think when they say he slept with a porn star, they meant literally. Does he even wear suits to court, or is it just footy pajamas and a nightcap? The Supreme Court yesterday declined to take up a case that would block a Texas law that requires pornographic websites to verify the age of users. Oh, no. However, will kids bypass this? If you're 17 and you can't figure this out, you don't deserve pornography. I mean, it's not exactly hacking into the Matrix. The House passed a bill yesterday that would end federal protection for gray wolves and remove them from the endangered species list. And you know what that means? The McWolf is back. The New York Times published exit interviews with 12 departing members of Congress yesterday, and several representatives said that the best perk of the job was the House of Representatives gym, while the worst part of the job is this House of Representatives gym. Screenwriter Aaron Sorkin revealed in a new interview that he's working on a new movie about Facebook's involvement in the Capitol attack. He's hoping it'll be out in time for the next one. Walt Disney World announced yesterday that one of the theme park's restaurants earned a Michelin star, said one guest, "The hell is this?" TSA agents at Miami International Airport recently discovered a bag filled with snakes in a man's pants, and it was worth it for the headline. I would like to talk to you about the logic of that joke later, Scollins. And finally, according to a new survey, more than half of employed Americans said that they feel like their skills are a little outdated, like since we invented teleprompters. It's fine, Wally. It's a joke. Okay. All right. And that, there we go. President Biden spoke today about the pro-Palestinian protests on college campuses for roughly 3 minutes, and then he got the hell out of there.
Thank you.
Mr. President, do you think the National Guard should intervene?
No.
Mr. President, do you agree with what the students are calling for?
Mr. President.
Man, he left that press conference the way I used to leave the kitchen when my mom asked to see my report card. No, I didn't get it. Yeah, no, my teacher is sick or something. No. When asked today if he thinks the National Guard should intervene in protests on college campuses, President Biden said no, but yes, if anyone brings their guitar to the quad. Prosecutors argued today that former President Trump should be sanctioned again for violating his gag order. Apparently, he talks in his sleep. In a new interview, former President Trump said that he would accept the results of the election, quote, if everything's honest. Dude, if everything was honest, the only results you'd have to accept would be the results of the prison talent show. Former President Trump is set to speak later this month at the Libertarian National Convention. Well, that ought to go well. We love libertarians always letting us check out books and telling us to keep our voices down, inventors. Inventors of the Dewey Decimal System, which we love so much. We don't understand it, but we love it. It's not meant to be understood. Former President Trump's campaign is reportedly starting to worry that independent presidential candidate Robert F. Kennedy Jr. is infringing on his preferred media outlets, including Fox News, Newsmax, and the guys yelling on the train. A Catholic priest in Pennsylvania was arrested recently after he allegedly charged more than $40,000 for mobile games on his church's credit card. Oh, so that's what a priest has to do to get arrested. That's right. That's right. A Catholic priest was arrested recently after he allegedly charged more than $40,000 for mobile games like Candy Crush on his church's credit card. Honestly, it's just good to hear his crush was on candy. The restaurant chain. The restaurant chain Red Lobster is reportedly considering filing for bankruptcy amid increased costs, which explains their new Endless Barnacles deal. Sunday is Cinco de Mayo, an important Mexican holiday, celebrating the victory of white people over happy hour. In a new interview, South Dakota Governor Kristi Noem defended killing her puppy and said, quote, I make tough decisions. What tough decisions are you talking about? The decision to listen to the voices? I say, yeah, I stand by. That's my favorite one. I mean, we both thought it'd go a little better, but it's still real good. And finally, scientists in England recently revealed the facial reconstruction of a Neanderthal woman that was buried about 75,000 years ago in a cave. Or it might have just been another courtroom sketch. And that was a monologue.